My next full build is AMT's Ford Courier Minivan. It's a little tiny pickup like the Chevy Love and the Toyota pickup. They were trying to compete with the mini truck craze coming out, and this is what Ford produced with a little four banger under the hood. It's a two-in-one kit. You have option of building a completely stock factory truck, or you can build up the cool minivan with the bed and the big topper on the back and everything. So let's take a look at all the parts that'll be in the box when you get yours. It has two different glass options for that topper in the back. I love the pre-smoked glass. You got clear glass for the back, and we've got clear glass for the cab with a sunroof option. So we'll show you that in just a second. You've got a set of four pad printed Firestone Super Sports tires, black wall if you don't want to use the white pad printed, and a nice tread pattern on them. Looks very stock, very nice. We got two metal axles to support the vehicle. We've got two chrome trees with wheel options, bumpers. We got optional parts for the engine. We got a nice little brush guard here in chrome. Grill and headlights are all one assembly. Rear bumper options, roll pan in the front for the spoiler down there. We've got the nice stock wheel option there. You can see it closer. We've got some dress up parts for the engine. We got little mirrors there and tail lights. We've got the optional turbine style wheels. They got the holes for the wires back there. Black wash inside of those, flat coat, they're gonna look like real metal. And an expanded decal sheet. All kinds of stripe options on this one. You've got three entire striping options that I can see for this. You got ones for the topper to go around it. You've got the reddish, the orangish stripe. You got Courier logos in white here, California plates. You got three different blue, white, and red Ford options. Freewheeler. We got some Michigan Centennial or Bicentennial plates. Very nice decal options in the box. Let me switch to the styrene. You'll be happy because it's molded in white styrene. We can see we've got our topper box. Big clear window on the top. Big windows on the side so you can use the smoked out option or the clears or any mix and match of those. We got our bed. Our tailgate. It does have the raised letters. If you want to leave it plain without the letters, and you know, you can have it so that they are just embossed on there and leave it. If you want to do a more basic pickup truck, or you can add those decals to bring out the letters on it. We got the Courier logos molded in, and we have decals to put over those, or you could sand them off, put the decals in there completely in their place. The back is open on this one. We'll be inserting a part in there. These two pieces get removed. They just do it for stability and molding and in packaging. We've got our stock bedsides here with cleats for tie downs, wheel backs. We've got a roll bar, fender flares, nice interior tub. The interiors on these were pretty basic, and so is, but you can see, we'll get in there close. We got window cranks, we got door handle, we got armrest, all done up in a vinyl if you wish. Full frame on this one, CB radio option, full exhaust system out the back. I like that full frame on there, that's pretty cool. You don't see that, a lot of times they'll just mold the bottom and have you do everything. We've got the option sides for that topper so that the window cuts down deep. We got that front spoiler going on there. We've got our inner fenders. Dashboard, hood with full detail on the bottom, radiator support, differential, leaf springs for the back end. We got our two drive shafts. Yes, this little long pickup has two drive shafts because of the long box. Let's get the rest of the parts out here. We got that nice bench seat in the front. Radiator, belt and pulley system. We got a lot of parts for the four banger on here. Stock steering wheel. We got our block halves and transmission, intake, stock air cleaner, springs, sports steering wheel, which is surprisingly molded open. Firewall with a decent amount of detail on it. Got the back of the cab. Got parts of that lower front end. Here, what looks like we've got an oil pan and valve, or this might be a fuel tank. Misspeaking there. Front suspension. Carrier for the drive shaft. And that is it. That's all the stuff that's in the box when you get yours. This is available from modelroundup.com right now. They sent this over for a full build. I'm going to get the glue in mine up, and I'll be right back. Everything is glued together before I'm going to start painting, or as far as I'm going to take it. Very easy kit to assemble. The front suspension will be a little bit fiddly, but if you use the metal axle as required in the build, it makes everything line up much easier, so you're not going to have any problems. I've got the trees cut up so that I can get stuff into paint the way that I want to get it into paint. We can see we've got our exhaust, and I at first kind of thought this might be a really bad flashing, but it should be heat shield. As far as I know, going underneath, we can see it's got the two exhaust systems on there, the little heat shield, the CB radio. We'll get that all painted up because I want that CB radio to look like the old Cobras with the metal face. So I'll get it painted up with the exhaust on there. We've got our front body piece. That will be done in body color on this one. So we've got that there. That will be attached later with the grill and the front bumper. We've got our dashboard glued together. That is a nice assembly. Looks cool on there. We'll get that primed and painted. We got our battery. We got a reservoir tank. We got a drive shaft. We'll get all those painted on that tree. On this tree, we've got our air cleaner and our radiator hose. So we'll get those painted up together. I definitely want to use the little brush guard on it. You can see I'm using the roll bar on the back, and I want that brush guard. I saw an ad for these pickup trucks that had the roll bar and the brush guard. So that's definitely the theme I want to go with, but it's not a chrome brush guard in the ad. It is all black, so I need to get paint on that. The hood, rarely do I attach the hood hinges, but it looks like this one of the only ways to hold the hood up in the back is the hinges. And they have large locating areas, so I did glue them in. If they don't work out, I can always just clip those off even and stick the hood on. But I put those on there. I'll leave it on the tree. We'll get it painted. Then I can just cut the hood off and touch up the sliver of plastic on the back with some paint from the can and a small brush. Got the belt and pulley system together. That looks nice on there. We'll get that all painted up as one piece. We got our wheel backs that are going to need paint. Our fuel tank, which I'll be painting up with the exhaust, a metallic tone. We got that nice bench seat. We can paint it out of the interior at the time so that we can make sure we get it primed and get some detail on it. The wheels shouldn't be super bright chrome, but they should be metallic. So I will hit these with a matte coat, some black washing, and some black paint. Really accent those star wheels out nicely. Got the steering wheel glued together. That's ready to go in some paint. That little four banger goes together, makes a nice looking little engine. I did put the valve cover and the carburetor on so I can get it all painted up. Then I will hand detail the parts on the side and the transmission. Got our little starter back there even. Got a little oil filter, distributor. You could wire the engine if you so chose. Nice little representation of that four cylinder, and in the parts it's got the turbo option for that model, so you can also do that if you wish. And now you can see the truck with its little sub assembly, how nicely it goes together. So I could just set it all together for you and show it to you. We got that nice roll bar, assemble that into the back of the truck, and then set it off separately so I can get it painted. I don't want it the same color as the truck, so I want that separately. We got the box here. I did the standard truck box. I want the little sporty truck. I'm not going for the custom topper look, which has the cutouts in the box. I do like that look. Unfortunately, I can't do both. There's only one bed bottom. But if they did have two, I would have built that up to show you how that looks. But I mean, pretty much just imagine we got the topper here. And then we assemble everything. You can see how nice and tall it is. It's going to look real tough and cool on the back. So it would be a cool looking option. And I did that on the Chevy Love that I built. So this one I went straight pickup truck with it. This one, the box build's so easy. I put on the driver's side first. You can see it lines up with these tabs down here. Once that was glued in, I put the front of the box on. The box has tabs that are size small and big, so you can't reverse it. You have to put it on one way. You can't make a mistake. Then I put on the passenger side, line up those rails at the bottom, glue it in tight, goes right around the fender. You can see the little markers inside in the fenders. Then I assembled the tailgate and attached it, and it still operates. So that's pretty cool. If you want to glue it in place, go ahead. If you want it to operate, I haven't done one with an operating tailgate. This one went together so smooth, even though it was a multi-piece bed, that I said, heck, I'll just leave it, and the paint will make it a lot tighter back there. So we'll just leave it as it is. That's ready to go. The cab we will take off fits over the fenders. Leave the interior down there. The back of the cab goes on nicely. I did not use any filler. Has a little tiny gap back there, but the rest glues in. Has nice tabs on the inside. So you can put the back on the cab. Some models you can't. I'm not going to do the sunroof on this one, but you could easily do it. Those marks are so big in there. You would just take your X-Acto knife or your scriber and go round and round and round and round and round till you saw it start coming through the roof. Then you could take your X-Acto knife and cut through the roof and get it out real easy without a problem, and your sunroof will pop right in there. So the body is ready to go. We'll get that painted up, my chosen color. The interior, I glued the firewall on the front just to make sure I had it all lined up nicely. And we will go in, get some paint on that. Make sure to paint the bottom. It's a full frame, so you're going to see the bottom of it if you turn the vehicle over. This is all the chassis. Yes, I'm going to do the inner fenders and the radiator mount in the same color, and those all key into each other. You can see they've got tabs to line up around the fenders, so it all goes on very well. The fenders have tabs that only fit in one direction, so you can't get the wrong fender on the wrong side. And that is a nice assembly with the radiator on there. We can get the frame assembled. Because there is a carrier for the drive shaft, I can put the second drive shaft in, got my metal axles in, got my differential on, got the shocks in. You can see how they mount. Got the front suspension and the springs all together. I write the numbers on smaller parts that are directional so I know which side I'm going on. Got our front suspension, got the metal axles in it, which also gives me something to hold on to while I get that painted. And we'll get that all hosed down with some spray paint. So this is everything that's going over to paint, and I'll be over there right now.
Thank you.
a little rundown on where everything sits before I do final assembly. Now you'll notice the paint looks a little grainy. I sprayed it with the VHT enamel, never had a problem with it before. It's been so humid lately that it's got a really rough finish to it. I stripped it once already, repainted it, got the same results. I do have the dehumidifier running down here, but it's just not helping this time of year. Beginning of August, it's insanely humid, but I'll throw some future floor polish on it. We'll deal with it. I'm not reviewing the paint anyways. I'm reviewing how much fun this kit is. So the paint finish, if I just did it all in primer, wouldn't matter anyways. We want to just see how the kit goes together, and that's what I've done. The interior looks pretty cool for being a very basic import fighter of the late 70s. I got that dash done. You saw me do that with the detail. I got that cool little CB radio in there. We got the khaki interior with the basic door panels, the black dash, the black steering wheel, and then the dashboard itself decorated up, and the CB radio glued into place with a little shifter in the floor. So that looks cool. That's going to look nice inside the truck. Got the grill done. Really like that little assembly. We got the front bumper on there. We got the grill blackwashed. I painted around the headlights and cleaned it all the way up so it looked like the box art, where it's more, there's just a little bit of chrome trim around the edges. Got that front trim piece glued on. Got the bumper glued on. When we're all done, that will just fit right into the front of the truck like so, and it'll look like our little Ford Courier. It'll give it its little face when we're all done there. Got the rear bumper to go on, got the CB antenna, got the brush guard. The brush guard will fit once that front bumper is on. The brush guard will go right in the front like that with its little lights. That's gonna look cool, little accessory piece. We got our air cleaner, we got our radiator hose, the bed's ready to go. I got the cleats done in Sharpie. Got the tail lights on, the other cleats, we just need to put the four decals on. We need to glue the little accessory roll bar in there. That's going to look nice in the back. The chassis is all set up, ready to go. Highlighted some of the cabling in the fenders, did the battery, did the reservoir tank, put the cap on the radiator, glued the engine in place, glued the fuel tank in place. Got that all set up, looks lovely underneath there. And got that awesome set of Firestone Super Sports wrapped around those star wheels. They look very realistic. Nice job with the molding. You saw me use the razor knife to clean them out a little bit and then drop some black wash in there to deepen that up. And that looks wonderful. So that is it. Very simple kit. I will decide which of the decals. These ones are set up if you use the cool topper on the back. These two can be used when you decorate it normally. Don't forget your tailgate stripe as well. I'm going to glue all those parts together, put the decals on it, wipe on a couple coats of Future to help that gloss on the paint job, and I'll be right back. And now, I've completed AMT's 125th scale 1978 Ford Courier Minivan, as they call it, or I call it a mini truck, is what this is. That's where they started to compete with the import boys, even putting the cleats on the side of the bed like the Yodas and the Mazdas coming in, and we've got the nice-looking Ford Courier to show for it. Sent over by Model Roundup. This is available right now at their website. I will link down in the description where you can snag it from Jack and Kirk and all the cool guys at Model Roundup. We thank them for supporting the channel. The model, easy to put together. Final assembly provides no struggles. What you do is I glued the interior to the pegs that I showed on the chassis. Then I just pushed the cab down over that. Then I just attached the box to the four points in the back where it glues right in place. I used some gel super glue to hold it fast. The bumper just pushes right onto the body. There's actually a large and small slot where that will slide in. And the front end just slots right into the radiator support and fits between the fenders, and everything lines up the way it should the first time without screaming or fighting. The brush guard is just attached with a couple drops of gel super glue. Same with the roll bar, same with the CB antenna, and the side mirrors I've got on there. It went together so well, I was even able to put on the rear view mirror, which sometimes I struggle with and throw in the garbage and we don't talk about it. But yeah, I even got that to go on because that's how easy the kit goes together. The little four popper underneath the hood looks nice. This, what I would call, would be the eccentric uncle to the Ford Ranger that would come out soon after these. That was the ubiquitous mini truck that we saw forever and went unchanged forever. That Ford Ranger, nice little trucks they were. And, you know, the S10 came from the Chevy Love later and all that kind of stuff. These were the little guys that started it all, the import fighters. They were selling a gajillion of the Datsuns and the Toyotas, and they said, we got to come out with trucks that are similar. This is what people want that don't need a full size, and this is where they were. The funny thing is, after these, the Rangers were a little bit bigger, and then everything started to get bigger. All the Chevy went to the S10, then went to the Colorado. I have a Tacoma, which is gigantic. My Tacoma's the size of a T100. It's hilarious how the mini trucks over the years have kept getting bigger. And I wish they would also introduce a line to bring back these little guys, which were so handy. And this kit was easy to put together. The decals, you can see, went on beautifully. I pushed mine down a little farther. The box art has them down where I do. On the directions, they have you having it up over the door handles, and I wanted it below the door handles so it would look nicer and sit low, and it even rolls over the fender with decal solvent and lays right down. My paint job on the exterior is not the best, but two coats of Future floor polish did bring that up to a much better shine, and I like the way it looks with that floor polish on there. So my recommendation, don't forget to turn on your dehumidifiers if you work in your basement in Wisconsin in the beginning of August, because it was 78% humidity down here, and that's what kind of screwed up the gloss on my paint job. But it came out all right, doesn't look too bad. The Ford decal on the back and the decal on the tailgate, a little bit of decal solvent, they both conform to the letters and the dip in the back and look phenomenal. The license plates, the Ford Courier logos on the side, no problems. The grill has high detail, didn't need one decal, just some black washing and a little bit of paint around the headlights, and that looks wonderful. There'll be pictures of the interior and the engine at the end. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. We thank ModelRoundup.com for sending this over. They are such great support, and they have more inbound to the show. We'll be seeing more cool stuff from them for years to come as they succeed at business because they treat people right. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.